Hello student, I am making this video for the student of class 8 and we are reading the very first lesson of unit 1, the food we eat. Let's go through the first para of this lesson, which says all living things need food to live. Plants make their own food with the help of soil, water, and sunshine. Animals eat plants or other animals for their food. Human beings eat all kinds of food which they get from plants as well as animals. The very first para says that every living thing needs food. Without food, no living thing can live. And only plants have ability to make their own food. Except plants, not even a single creature has this power to produce food. Not even a single animal has power to produce their own food. Except plants have the power to make their own food, and they make their own food through a process called photosynthesis with the help of soil, water, and sunshine. I'm sure you have read it. About photosynthesis in your science subject. Animals eat plants or other animals' food. Some animals, that is herbivorous animal, eat plants or plant products. While carnivores eat the flesh of other animals. Similarly, we, the human beings, eat all kind of food, means vegetables as well as the flesh of other animals. So we human beings eat all kinds of food that is vegetarian food as well as non-vegetarian food, which we get from plants as well as animals. The food that we eat comes from both plants as well as animals. We get fruits, vegetables, pulses, rice, wheat from plants. At the same time, we get milk, eggs, fish, or something else from animals or from birds. Let's move towards the another para, that is the second para of this lesson. We need energy to work, to think, to play. We need energy even when we are asleep. Our heart needs energy to keep beating. We need energy even to breathe. And it is our food alone that provides us all this energy. Second para says something about energy. Yes, energy means ability to do work. The second para says about energy. And you all know that we need energy to work, to think, and also to play. We need energy even for other activities like sleeping, laughing, etc. Even our internal organs, that is heart, lungs, etc., also need energy to do their work. as our heart needs energy to keep beating. We need energy even to breathe, even to breathe and to do something else. And the energy we need comes from food that we take. In short, we can say that it is our food that provides us energy, which helps us in doing our work. Let's go through the third para. Every day, millions of cells in our body die. They have to be replaced by new cells. Again, it is our food that provides the material to build new cells. Third para says that millions of cells die in our body per day, each and every day. And these cells have to be replaced by new cells, means at the place of cells which die in our body every day, new cells grow up again. What enables to do this? Again, our food that we provides our body the material which our body need to develop or to make new cells. The fourth para, the more active a person is, the more energy his body consumes. Children are always more active than older people. Their bodies are still growing. They need more energy, more bodybuilding materials. Therefore, it is very important for them to take rich, nutritious and wholesome food. Fourth para says that the more active a person remains, the more energy his body needs. It means energy requirement of our body depends how busy we are, how active we remains. If we remains more active, then our body will need much more energy. At the same time, if we remain inactive, our body will not need as much energy as an active person needs. And children always remain active. Sometimes they are found more active than the older people. Moreover, their bodies are still growing, and so they need more energy to do various things, various activities like playing, walking, jumping, etc. At the same time, their body also need much more energy to build up various organs, as the body of children keep growing. And therefore, it becomes very important for them to take rich, nutritious and wholesome food so that their body may get energy that they need. Let's go through another para of this lesson. Food supplies us substance, says that we need to live and grow. We call these substances nutrients. They include proteins, fats, carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, and water. No one nutrient is more important than the other. It means each and every nutrient is equally important. even one has its own work to do. A healthy balanced diet has the right proportion of all the six nutrients, that is proteins, fats, carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals and water. So that's all in this video. But don't forget, I will send your homework from this lesson. Okay, so see that lesson, the homework that you will have to do. You will have to solve question number 1 and question number 2, and of course question number 3. So you will have to write the answer of the first 3 questions, first number 1, number 2 and number 3. So that's all for today. Thank you.